And happy new month of February. Amen. We are already a month old. Praise God. Feliz Domingo por la mañana. Pastors José and Patricia, we want to welcome you to New Beginnings Church of the Big Ben. Amen. Praise the Lord. We're a church, come join us, a church you can call home. Where we honor God, we love families, we serve others, and we pursue excellence. Amen. Bienvenidos a la Iglesia Nuevo Comienzo. And welcome to our NBC family. All visitors and all of you that are joining us by audio and video. Amen. Prepare yourselves to receive. God has something for me. You need to say that to yourself on a daily basis. God has something for me. God has something special for you. And I want it. Amen. So praise God. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
Woo. Don't allow the word of God pass you by. Lord, he's got something for you. He's not finished with you yet. Amen. What we need to do is we need to make ourselves available.
Yeah.
Amen. Make yourself available. Lord, here am I. Use me. And yes, he will. Amen. Ooh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. We're going to continue with patiently waiting on him. I guess you could say number two. Amen. So he's not finished with you. He has great plans for you. Just make yourself available and you can do all things through him. Praise God.
Amen.
You're a winner. You're a champion. And you're an overcomer.
Amen.
See yourself the way he sees you. You need to write these things and remind yourself, I need to see myself the way he sees me. You know what? That this world is going to see you disqualified, unqualified, not good. Amen? So, see yourself the way he sees you. He didn't make junk. He made you an original. Amen? So, remember that. Don't die a copy for somebody else. Be the original God made you to be. Ooh, man.
Yeah.
I'm blessed already. So, let's grab our Bibles and let's make this declaration together.
Yes.
Amen? So,
thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Are you ready?
Yes.
Say it like you mean in church, okay? This is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. Continue. I'm talking the word of God. I boldly confess. My mind is alert. My spirit is receptive. And I'll never be the same in Jesus' name. Are you receiving, church?
Yes.
You got to receive it. Amen. You got to receive it for yourself. Don't come and say, well, you know, if so-and-so was here, this would have been great for so-and-so. Man, no. This is for you. Amen.
Amen.
I want to receive it. So you know what? So you can get be equipped to go and do what God called you to do. Amen.
Yes.
And he didn't forget about you.
That's it.
That's what the world says. That's what people say. You know, God can't use you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you failed too much. You've done this. You've done that. Whatever.
Mm-hmm.
God doesn't need you anymore. God can't use you anymore. That's a lie.
Yes,
it
Amen.
Is. That's why it's so important. You know what the word of God says. So that you can continue. He says, you know, hey, all of us fall once in a while, but you know what? It's your choice to get back up. I want to get back up. I don't want to stay down. Amen. I am not defeated.
That's it.
I'm a child of God. I'm going to get up and I'm going to press on and do what God called me to do. He's done the same for you. If you've fallen, if you failed, if you sinned, whatever, you know, confess it and press on, you know, confess it and press on with him. Don't stay down. You choose to stay down, that's your fault. That's not God's fault. Amen. Like I said many times, the problem's not with him. The problem is here. We got to fix this. We got to get this right. Amen. So we got to get the word in here so we can start doing what the word of God tells us to do. Amen. And start following what the word of God tells us to do. And the Bible says you can do all things through Christ. Amen. Not some things, but all things. Amen. Don't let people, don't let the world, don't let anything limit you to what the word of God says you can do.
That's it.
If it says you can do all things, then I'm going to hold them to it, you know. And I'm going to press on you regardless of what people are saying. Sometimes we just got to go through, you know. People are saying negative things. People are saying this, that, whatever, you know. Still, I'm not going to hear what they're saying. I'm going to press on with what the word of God is saying. Amen. So, praise God. Are you happy? Can you say amen or
amen?
Amen. Amen. We're going to continue with patiently waiting on him. Patiently waiting on him. Number two. Amen. Living in this impatient, ungodly world full of rage, full of anger, full of wrath. Amen. I mean, you see it all the time. And if you don't spend your time with him before you step out into the world, you're going to find out quick. And they're going to find out where you stand real quick. Are you in him or are you in the world? Because it's going to come out of you. We got to feed on the word so that his word can can come out. We got to feed on his word so that we can start seeing things with love and compassion.
Amen.
And then if we start dealing with the flesh, man, I can go one for one with you on the in the flesh. But what about the word? What about him? What did Jesus do? He's our greatest example. Are we doing what Jesus told us to do? Going to all the world and teach the good news. Amen. Be the light to a dark world. And man, it's dark out there.
Yep.
And it's negative and it's impatient, you know. But you got to get it in you so that you can go out and see the world with his love and his compassion. And you see it through his eyes and not these eyes. You know, the Bible says we walk by faith and not by sight. You know, I can walk by sight and, you know, I can see a lot of bad things, a lot of ungodly things. But if I'm walking out in faith, you know, I oversee those things and deal with it with the word. Amen. How do I deal with it? With the word.
Yes.
With his love and his compassion. Amen.
Yeah.
Start a new year. Start every day with a new attitude. What's my new attitude going to be this year? My new attitude is this. Have an attitude of winning, a winning attitude, and not a losing attitude. You know, we've been programmed by this world to be negative all the time.
All the time.
Because they're going to put you down no matter what you do. You know, you're trying to please the world, you ain't never going to please the world. Be a God pleaser, not a people pleaser, not a world pleaser, because you'll never live up to it. Amen. So let's remember this. Who are we going for? We're pressing on for him. We're pressing on for him. We're going on with him. Don't hold yourself back and don't let the world or anybody hold you back. We're pressing on. Every way you should be reading the Bible says, press on. It didn't say stop. It didn't say go back. Mm-hmm. It says press on.
Yeah.
We're going forward. We haven't talked about the armor of God, but all the whole armor deals with the front. It doesn't deal with the back.
That's it.
We're not going to turn around and run back.
That's it.
We're going to press on, go forward. As a matter of fact, one point when he says, don't look back. Lot's wife, she looked back and what happened?
She
lost.
Yes, she did.
Amen. She lost. So ain't nothing to go back to.
That's it.
Amen. We got to keep pressing on.
Amen.
I'm going to read it to you in both ways, but you can open your Bibles. Those of you watching, those of you listening, our text is Isaiah chapter 40 and verse 31. Amen. We're continuing with this. It says, King James says, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. We need his strength on a daily basis. Daily basis, not once in a while.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, you're fighting a spiritual battle. And you can't do it with the physical body.
That's it.
If you do, you're going to lose every time.
Yeah.
We got to get in the word, and we need his strength. We need, when it talks about strength, we're talking about, we need his authority.
Yes.
We need his word to press on in this world. Amen.
Yeah.
So it says, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles.
Amen.
And we got to be like eagles and rise up above all these problems. What problems are coming against you? Maybe different than mine, but still, you can rise up above your problems, whatever problems you're facing.
Amen.
They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Amen. Don't let anything hold you down. Don't let anything be so big that you think it's bigger than your God.
That's it.
Ain't nothing bigger than God.
That's
Amen.
It.
We need to tell our little problems how big our God is.
Yes.
Amen. That's what we need to do. And a lot of times we got this reversed, you know, where we're magnifying our problems and not our God.
That's it.
We got to get it right, you know, say, I'm going to stop saying those things. Because we hear somebody else say, you know, how big the problems they have.
Mm.
Start telling your problems how big your God is.
Yes.
Amen.
Yeah.
And some people need to hear this. They need to hear it come from you. Mm-hmm. So they say, man, I want what they've got. Amen. That's the word of God. They've got Jesus. Amen. And I need Jesus. I want what you've got. What is it you've got? I've got Jesus. You know, it's my Lord and Savior. That's what they need. The Amplified says like this, but those who wait on the Lord, who expect, I'm expecting, look for and hope in him, will gain new strength and renew their power.
Yes.
Amen. We need their spiritual power. We need that. Amen. They will lift up their wings. They will lift up their wings and rise up close to God, like eagles racing towards the sun. They will run and not become weary. Mm-hmm. They will walk and not grow tired. Amen.
Yes.
If you're just physically in the flesh, your flesh is going to get tired.
Yes.
Amen. But we got to feed in the Word, and we got to take, like I said, I told the church a few minutes ago, we need some break, Bible breaks. You know, we take breaks for everything. Coffee breaks, smoke breaks, whatever kind of break you take. But we need a Bible break once in a while.
Mm-hmm.
We need to go and get in the Word and read it. Amen. Build ourselves up.
Mm-hmm.
Stir ourselves up in the things of God. If you're not doing this, you know, you start dealing in the flesh. And if you're not in the Word, you're in the flesh.
Yeah.
Even as a child of God, if you're not feeding on the Word, you're going to fall.
Yeah.
Because you're in the flesh and not in the spirit.
Uh-huh.
We got to feed our spirit with the Word of God. We got to renew our minds daily, often, with the Word of God. If you're not doing those things, the world, you're going to take on the world. And you're going to take on the cares of the world. And you're going to start dealing with it in the flesh. And you're defeated already.
Mm-hmm.
You got to start confessing what the Word of God says.
Yes.
Speaking the Word of God.
Speaking the word.
Amen. Speaking the truth. And that truth is going to set you free.
Yes.
Amen. So we're going to review a few things and then we're going to get going again. Amen.
Amen.
So wait. We got to wait patiently, confidently, expecting in faith, hope, and trust.
Yes.
And obey what He tells us to do.
Yes.
Amen. So wait is also trusting in God's timing.
Yes.
It's His timing. Remember, if you go and you pray, you leave it, and then you trust faithfully and have patience that He's going to answer it His timing. He knows when it's ready.
Amen.
He knows when it's time for you, when it's the right time for you. We have some on there, Scott, somewhere, but they're all over the place anyway. We need to let go and let God.
Mm-hmm.
We need to let go and let God give it to Him because He knows what's best for us. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And another scripture is, there you go. Pray, relax, let go, and let God
do the
rest.
Yes.
But we try to help Him out.
No. Yeah.
He don't need our help. The only help He needs us, the only help He needs from us is pray and step out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
Get out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Trusting you. That's trusting Him. Having faith.
Yes.
And expect. He's going to take care of it. No problems. I have no problems with that. There we go.
Amen.
Give it to God. Let go and let God handle it.
Yes.
You let go. You just go like this. I'm out of this. I'm letting God have it. Amen. Praise God. Keep going. Those are good. Let God have His way in your life.
Uh-huh.
The Bible says in James 4:7, submit yourself to God. Resist the devil.
Uh-huh.
And he will flee from you.
Uh-huh.
Amen. It says, let God have His way in your life.
Mm-hmm.
Are you letting God have His way in your life? If not, you know, things are going to happen.
Yeah.
And it's not because of Him. It's because we got to get it right.
Yes.
And we got to get it in order. We got to get ourselves in order.
Yes.
He is already in order. He showed us the way. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody goes to the Father except through Him. So we need to know the way.
Yes.
He's showing us the way, but we need to follow. Amen. Woo. Man, those are good. Psalms 27:14, Scott, if you can find that, please.
27:14.
And it goes like this. It goes, King James says, wait in faith and patiently on the Lord. Be of good courage, and He shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Amen. If the Word tells us to wait, you know, we need to know to wait and be patient.
Amen.
Just pray, relax,
uh-huh.
have patience, and have faith. Amen.
Yes.
The Amplified says this. It says, wait for and confidently, surely expect the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Be strong and let your heart take courage.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, wait for and confidently, surely expect the Lord. I'm expecting the Lord.
Yes.
But that's on his timing.
His timing, yeah.
You know, we're in this instant world that we want everything now.
Mm.
You know, we forget about Him, and all of a sudden we have a need, and we go straight to Him, and we need it now. And we need an answer now. And we put a demand, you know. We want it now. So Wayne is trusting God in his timing. Amen.
Yes.
Woo, praise God.
Praise God. Thank you.
Where are we? Oh, all right. Leave it right there.
Okay.
Says, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into divers temptations, mm-hmm. knowing this, that the trial of your faith worketh
yes.
patience.
Patience.
So we're trusting Him. Amen.
Amen.
We're trusting Him, and we're going to have patience over this thing. Amen. Regardless of, you know, your body is so uneasy, and it starts to pacing, and it starts to just wanting it now.
Yeah.
But we're with the Word.
Yes.
In the Word,
yes.
we will have patience and
Amen.
Wait on Him. It says, those that wait upon the Lord shall Amen. Renew their strength.
That's
Amen.
It.
Ooh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's see. Where are we? Here. Keep going, Scott. Okay, yeah, patience is included in the fruit of the Spirit.
Yes.
It says, fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. Amen. So yeah, it's in there, but you know what, we have to develop it.
Yes,
it's in there, but we have to develop it. How do we develop it? Well, we got to get in the Word,
mm-hmm.
and we got to study, and we got to meditate and have the peace and the patience. Amen. Praise
yeah.
God. Thank you, Lord. Mm-hmm. It says we've been conditioned by this world to be impatient.
Sure.
We want it now. We need it now. Mm. And you know, we don't hold back. We let God know. we go put the demand in and say, Lord, I need it now. Amen. We don't want to wait. We can't wait. We don't put it off. Mm. It's now, Lord. We need it now.
Mm-hmm.
We must get it now. Do it now and have it now.
Yes.
And that's pretty bold to go up to God and demand these things like this. You say, trust me. Trust and obey. Amen.
Yes, amen.
We also have a fast and instant world of fast services. Everything is fast, 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 you know?
Mm-hmm.
So we do need to be patient because we're so conditioned by the world and wanting everything fast. We come to God and we want it just like we go and do the world, you know. We can't treat God the same way, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Nope. Not so. Okay. Again, our text. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength.
Amen.
They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint.
Yes.
Amen. So wait on the Lord, then we must mount up with wings and eagles and run and not be weary.
Yes.
And we shall walk and not faint.
Amen.
See yourself soaring high with
Amen.
God.
Yes.
Not scratching with the chickens.
That's it.
And not eating mess with the pigs.
Yes.
Amen. So praise
right.
God. So see yourself the way He sees you. He sees
Amen.
You running. He sees you soaring.
Yes.
He sees you walking. And we must
yes.
press on, being overcomers, being winners, being champions, seeing yourself
yes.
the way He sees you. All these things. But you know, we got to get in the Word and find out what the Word says. So we know what it says.
Yes.
And we start confessing these things
right,
so that
right.
we can reprogram ourselves to think the way God wants us to think, the way He made us,
yes.
not the way the world has programmed us, you know. They want you to think this way and be this way.
Mm-hmm.
No, you don't have to be that way.
That's it.
Amen. Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
Overcoming the world with your overcoming the world and your cares, your problems, your troubles, your setbacks. Some of these failures, lacks, or anything, or any distractions that cause you to fall.
Yeah.
These things, you know, we've been confessing and doing the wrong things, and they're going to cause you to fall.
That's it.
Because you're going opposite of what the Word of God tells
That's
you to
it.
Do.
That's it.
And you're thinking what the world, and you're doing the same thing over and over, like insanity, doing the same thing over and over, and expecting different results.
That's it.
We got to get it right. Get the Word and do what the Word says.
Yes.
Man.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. I'm going to read you a little scripture here in Mark, if you want to follow along. But it says in Mark chapter 4, verses 35 through 40. Amen. And mine is the New King James, so you read it from your translation.
Mark
chapter 4, verse 35 through 40.
Okay.
It says, goes like this, 35. On the same day when evening had come, he said to them, Jesus said to them, says, let us cross over to the other side. You know, if Jesus is talking to you and Jesus says we're going to the other side,
we're going to make it
to the other side. Okay? So regardless of what happens, you know what's going to happen. You know what we're going to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
There's a storm rising up.
Yeah.
Things come up.
Mm-hmm.
But still, God has promised you
mm-hmm.
certain things.
Yes.
And he's a promise keeper, you know.
Yes,
he's
yes.
going to keep his promise. He's going to keep his word.
Yes.
And we got to remember, Lord, remember what your word says.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He likes it when you remind him. He says,
mm-hmm.
remember what your word says, Lord. We're going to the other side.
Mm-hmm.
He says, let us cross to the other side. 36. Now, when they had left the multitude,
mm-hmm.
they took him along in the boat as he was. And other little boats were also with them. But listen, it says, a great windstorm. I looked at windstorm, and these are some of the synonyms that was with it. It says, windstorm, it says, twister.
Oh boy.
Tornado.
Yeah.
Cyclone.
Mm.
And hurricane.
Oh geez.
So which one of these? These are pretty powerful winds, okay?
Yeah.
They're pretty strong.
Mm-hmm.
It says, arose, and the waves beat on the boat
mm-hmm.
so that it was already filling.
Mm-hmm.
It was getting filled. But he was on the stern, asleep on a pillow.
Yes.
Church, we're going to have storms of life
yes.
that will come daily. It's no concern to him.
Mm-hmm.
He went to sleep anyway. Whatever
yes.
storm, whatever storms trouble you, remember, the greater one is with you. Amen.
Amen.
They awoke him and they said to him, teacher, don't you care that
mm-hmm.
we perish?
Mm-hmm.
Then he arose and rebuked the wind and he said to the sea, be still.
Yeah.
And the wind ceased
mm-hmm.
and there was great calm.
That's it.
But he said to them, why are you so fearful?
Uh-huh.
What is it that you have no faith?
Mm.
Where is your patience?
Yes.
Immediately, he's our greatest example. He's showing us what to do. These
yeah.
storms of life will rise up, okay? And still, the greater one is in you.
Yes.
And the word is in you. And you're going to speak to these storms.
Mm-hmm.
Be still. Be calm.
Mm-hmm.
And I rebuke you in Jesus' name. Amen? So these winds was pretty powerful.
Yes.
I'm telling you what the synonym said. It says, twister, tornado, hurricane,
mm-hmm.
cyclones. These are pretty powerful.
Yes, yes.
Tsunamis.
Mm.
But still, he came. What did he do? He spoke the word.
Mm-hmm.
So we have the word of God. We need to speak the word. It's not just good for you to study it and have it in you. If you're going to have it in you, if you've got it in you and you're facing some things and you don't say anything, you're defeated.
Yeah.
Because you choose not to speak.
Right, right.
But if you speak to it,
yes,
you can overcome.
Yeah.
Amen. You can do what Jesus did. There was calmness. He spoke to the sea and said, be still.
Yes.
And the wind told the wind to cease.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a great calm.
Mm-hmm.
So those storms in your life can be calm.
Yes.
Now in Jesus' name. Wait a minute.
Yeah.
I'm not letting it get that bad.
That's it.
There might be some storms or getting to be storms, but you stop it now.
Yeah.
You take control of it now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Yeah.
Praise God.
God. Thank you, Jesus.
We can soar and overcome the world and Satan through him and
yes.
confessing his word.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
First John 4:4 says this, you're of God, little children, and have overcome them because he who is in you is greater than he that is in the world. I don't care what this world brings.
Yeah.
This world or the enemy, Satan.
Uh-huh.
You know, and Satan's mission, we already know. John 10:10
yeah.
says, he comes to steal, kill,
destroy.
And
destroy. Yeah.
Jesus' mission says,
mm-hmm.
my mission is this,
mm-hmm.
give you life and life more abundantly. Amen. But he says, greater is he that is in you.
Amen.
That word in you is greater than whatever the world can bring. So don't be afraid. Where is your faith?
Mm-hmm.
Speak the word. You have the word in you. You speak to those storms. Mm-hmm. Speak to those problems. Speak to whatever's coming against you.
Yes.
Amen. If you're not speaking to it, you know, you're defeating yourself. Mm-hmm. Because nothing is stronger and more powerful than the word of God.
Yes.
He said he used the word to speak this world into existence. Mm-hmm. He says, I send the word and it goes and accomplishes what
yes.
I send it to do.
What I send it to do. That's it.
And we see Jesus gave us the example right there. He spoke to the sea and he told the sea to be still.
Yeah.
These storms, be still.
Yeah.
And he spoke to the wind and says, cease.
Mm-hmm.
What am I doing? I'm confessing the word of God.
Yes.
But you are doing the same thing. You
yes.
can do this.
Amen.
Bible says, remember, you can do
all things
through Christ. Amen.
Yes.
It's not good enough when God's people are in bondage.
Yeah.
You know we're in bondage. Yes, we're enslaved. We're imprisoned to sin, bad habits, bad ways, and the mess of the world. Other things, other little foxes. It says that stop us from being free and victorious to do what God has called us to do.
Yeah,
you know it's just like a spider web. You know them little webs. They just gonna.
Yeah.
Get all over you and hold you down. I said, wait a minute. This can't hold me down.
Greater
is he that's in me than he that's in the world. I can do all things through
Christ.
Start confessing the word of
yes.
God. Let it come out of you. Don't never say, I can't learn scripture. I try, but I can't. Don't say that.
Mm-hmm.
You keep reading it and you keep meditating on it. You keep reading and meditating on it. And guess what? When you need it, it's going to come. It's going to be there. Because he says you can do all things. And that's learn the word also, you know. In Jesus' name. Church,
amen.
We got to let go of whatever makes you stop. What's making you stop? Whatever's making you stop may be different than mine.
Yeah.
But still,
mm-hmm.
we got to let it go.
Amen.
And let God
yes.
give it.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Let go and let God.
Yeah,
with
yeah.
him, all things are possible.
Yes.
Amen. All the impossibles become possible through
that's
him.
That's it.
Amen. You know the impossible? If you take the I am impossible,
mm-hmm.
I am possible with him. Amen. So with you.
yes.
Hallelujah. Praise God. One thing some of us are not good at is this. Having patience. Remember last week we were talking about the little boy that went fishing. The old man came. He was happy. Man, I'm so happy that you're fishing. Are you catching anything? What are you doing? Are you fishing? He says, no, I'm drowning worms.
Mm-hmm.
That was a bad attitude. But we gotta, you know, if you're going fishing,
mm-hmm.
if you're going to buy some equipment to go fish, you got to have some equipment.
Yeah.
And if you're going to go fish, you got to have some patience.
Yes.
Because it's going to take time.
Gonna take time.
If you're gonna go hunt,
yeah,
you gotta have the equipment to go hunt. But
yes.
mainly, you have to have patience.
Yes.
You and you know what I'm gonna do on the way?
Mm.
I'm gonna pray. And while I'm waiting, I'm gonna pray and have time with him and
Amen.
Praise him and worship him.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Even if I don't catch anything,
yes.
I'm expecting to catch, but
yes.
if I don't catch anything, I make myself happy. Because
right.
I spend time with him.
Amen.
I'm not talking negative. Well, I ain't going to bite today. Well, I ain't catching nothing today. Well, you're speaking defeat.
Yes.
Speak positive.
Amen.
Lord, thank you. This little animal, this little doe, whatever, this little deer is going to walk up. Well, man, I'm going to catch the most beautiful catfish or whatever fish, whatever you're fishing for.
Fish my bass.
Waiting in line, waiting in traffic. Oh my God, you're talking about so much rage in traffic.
Mm-mm-mm.
Waiting in the airport for my flight, and it's taking forever. I'm at the doctor's office visiting. Takes forever. And you know what? I just rescheduled my appointment, and it's 6 months from now.
Yeah.
I say, why can't I get it next week or tomorrow? You know, why is it 6 months from now?
Mm.
Impatience. Waiting for a mail, waiting for my check. It's going to take a while. Waiting for a call, and I'm not getting it.
Mm.
No, I'm waiting for Pastor to hurry up with this message. I see some signs back there saying, stop, stop. We start spacing. We start pacing the floors. Mm-hmm. We're easily get impatient. Mm-hmm. Rage. Listen, rage rises. Mm-hmm. And you'll notice real quick. Rage, because you start you start dealing with the flesh. Mm-hmm. And the flesh is going to show it.
Yeah.
People know, be careful. Your words and your actions are going to show real fast.
Yes.
And we'll find out who you've been dealing with. Mm-hmm. And who you've been spending your time with. Mm-hmm. So please stay cool in Him. We don't guard our mouth. Mm-hmm. Words start shooting out somewhere in there. Starting, mm-hmm. You'll see some shooting stuff. Some words coming out. But we start shooting our mouth. We start shooting words out, you know.
Uh-huh.
And we're not thinking about what we're saying.
Right, right.
And a lot of times it's negative. Mm. And you can have what you say. Mm-hmm. And you're sowing negative seed instead of positive seed.
That's it.
Amen. So you have to be careful. Yes. Listen to this. Words you speak are seeds you sow. Seeds you plant. Seeds you spread, seeds that you scatter. Mm-hmm. Anything you plant is going to grow.
Yeah.
And it's going to grow to you.
Your garden.
Not somebody else. You know, I have to give them a piece of my mind. I have to just let them know. Mm-hmm. No, but it's coming back to you.
Amen.
It's coming back to you, so you have to be careful. Words are also carriers. Words are carriers. They carry life or they carry death.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes.
They carry life or death, positive or negative.
That's it.
So you got to be careful. I don't want to be set. I don't want to be shooting out these words carrying negative things. Or, you know, here we go. Whoa. I'm not gonna name any names. Some of us are real good. Some of us have machine guns. Okay, we start shooting words out. Man, I can't believe you said those things. I can't believe they come out of you. Look at this. Death and life are in what? In the power of the tongue. Death and life are in the words you speak.
That's it.
So you have to be careful. And it's Proverbs 18:21.
Yeah.
So, you know, words. You know, we used to say this when we was playing games with, as kids, you know, sticks and stones can break my bones, but words will never hurt me.
Yes, they will.
That is wrong.
That's a lie.
Words can hurt. Okay? Words hurt. So you got to be careful. Yes, thank you. you see that snake, huh? Slaying there, kind of sneaky snake here. Says the tongue can no man tame.
That's it.
Train. Is an ungodly, unruly evil full of deadly poison.
Yes.
I don't want my words to be associated with this.
That's it.
I want my words to line up with what the Word of God says. Mm-hmm. Because you know what? When I start speaking the Word, good things will happen.
Yes.
Good things to come to pass.
Mm-hmm.
And not ungodly things like this. So we need to put a guard on our mouth and not shoot them out.
Amen.
Like this other person was. You got to be careful not to shoot off like that. So put a guard. I know them all. I can say them all, but I'm not letting them out. I'm putting a guard, and it's not going past the guard, okay? Oh, praise God. Death and life are in the power of the tongue.
Yes.
Words you speak. And they that love it will eat the fruit of it.
Thereof. Yes.
Okay, thereof. Mm-hmm. You will reap what you sow.
Yes.
Remember, the hardest thing to tame or train and discipline is the tongue. Mm-hmm. Let's remember this. You tell it what to say. Don't let it speak for you.
Yes, yes.
You tell it what to say. And you put it forward and says, you know, I was going to shoot this.
Hmm.
You know, we're selective of what we shoot. If I go hunting, I know what I want to shoot.
That's
I'm not going to shoot just anything.
That's it.
This is what I came for. This is what I want to shoot. So you be selective of what comes out of your mouth.
Amen.
And that's your choice. Well, they made me do this. No, nobody's going to make you You made yourself.
You made yourself.
So you have to be careful.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
James 3 and 8 says this. The tongue can no man tame. It is unruly evil, full of deadly poison. We saw a few minutes ago.
Amen.
Give no place to the devil. If you do, listen, you need to write this down. Give no place to the devil. If you do, he wants to rule you.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to control you. He wants to drive you. He wants to guide you. And he's going to drive you wrong. He wants to devour you. Remember, his mission, steal, kill, destroy.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing good about the enemy.
That's it. That's
he
it.
Wants to steal,
yes,
kill, and
it.
Destroy.
Yes.
Amen. There you go. John 10:10. And Jesus
Amen.
Said, Jesus' mission
mm-hmm.
says, I have come. Jesus says, I have come.
Oh.
That they, or you know, you,
yes.
put your name there. That Jose may have life. And
life.
That Jose might have it more abundantly.
Amen.
Amen. He didn't forget about you. He just
mm-hmm.
personalized this.
That's it.
Write on your Bible. Write on your
Amen.
Notes, you know, and say, this is for me.
Yes.
And you put your name on there. Scratch and write on there. It's for me. Put your name on to it. Amen.
Amen.
There we go. John 4:4. 1 John 4:4.
Mm-hmm.
You have God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he is
yes.
in the world. Greater
yes.
is he that is in me. You know, even David knew this.
Yes.
And he knew his God was bigger
yes.
than that giant facing him.
Okay.
And our God, Jesus, says, the Holy Spirit comes and lives in us.
Uh-huh.
He says,
uh-huh.
I'll go, but the Holy Spirit will come.
Mm-hmm.
And he's in you.
Yes.
And whatever giants are out there coming against you, greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world.
Amen.
And I'm going to start confessing what the Word of God says.
Amen. Praise
Amen.
God. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. I'll give you a few biblical examples of waiting on God.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody laugh at this. Abraham and Sarah.
Oh, boy.
God promised them a child.
Mm-hmm.
And they try to help God, but didn't work that way. He promised them a child, and you knew it was God because they were way past their age
mm-hmm.
of having children. But God gave them a child.
Yes,
and they tried to help God, and the wrong child was born.
Mm.
Okay? But finally, they had their child,
mm-hmm.
and Isaac was born.
Yes. Well,
praise God, they had their child.
Yeah.
Noah, they had a flood. Well, first of all, he told Noah, build an ark. He said, what's an ark?
Mm.
God showed him. But still,
yes.
after the flood came,
mm-hmm.
the waters subsided.
Mm-hmm.
And it took time.
Yes, it
He's
did.
Probably asking God, says, how long do I have to stay in this ark with all these animals? yay, what's up? He had to be patient.
Mm-hmm.
What about Joseph? Remember Joseph? All his brothers were jealous of him.
Mm.
No, dad loves him more.
Mm.
And you know, they sold him. They were first they wanted to kill him, but then they sold him to a slaver.
Mm-hmm.
And it took him a while to rise up to what God called him to be.
Mm-hmm.
And he was second in command over Egypt. Amen. Until his brothers came to ask him, you know, for things, for food and stuff, you know.
Yes.
But it took a while.
Mm-hmm.
How about Mary and Martha?
Mm.
Says they called Jesus. Jesus took his time. He knew. He took his time.
Mm-hmm.
And when he came, it's already been 4 days, you know.
Mm-hmm.
He stinks already.
Mm-hmm.
Why, you know? But Jesus called Lazarus out.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
He
called him out. Whatever your situation is, Jesus can still fix it. Amen.
Yes.
But you be careful what you're saying.
Yes.
The disciples, you know, he told the disciples, go in the upper room and wait.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sending the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, there was lots more than 120.
Mm-hmm.
And they couldn't wait. They got impatient. A lot of them walked out.
Yeah.
Amen. A lot of them walked out.
Mm-hmm.
And us believers, Jesus says he's coming back. And some of us are getting tired of waiting. How long will it take? How long will it take?
Uh-huh.
You know, as long as it takes.
Mm-hmm.
If the word says it, that he's coming back,
mm-hmm.
then believe it.
That's
and
it.
And be ready.
That's it.
Amen. The 10 virgins. Half of them was ready and half of them was impatient.
Yeah.
Still, you got to be ready.
Yeah,
in each case, they loved God. They knew the promises of God in his word. They rested on him, relied upon his love, his care, and his protection. They used patience, faith, hope, energy, and effort. Amen. So let's remember this.
Mm-hmm.
And in each case, it was worth the wait.
Yes.
In closing, remember this.
Mm-hmm.
If God did it for them,
mm-hmm.
he'll do it for us.
Yes.
Amen. He didn't forget about us.
No, yes.
He showed his great examples in the Bible so that we can read and say, he'll do it for me too.
Right, right.
Amen.
Amen.
So let's remember this. But what about us little children? I wrote this. It says, it's good for the spiritual giants, the Bible heroes, but what about us little children? What about us little people? How about us little grasshoppers? I told that to Patricia. She says, grasshoppers? I'm not a grasshopper. She says, the spies went into the promised land and they came back. She says, man, there's giants there. He says, we're like little grasshoppers amongst them.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see yourself like little grasshoppers amongst your problems, amongst your storms?
Mm-hmm.
My God is bigger.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And he sees you bigger and overcoming all these situations.
Mm-hmm.
So I can wait and be patient on the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And we're going to stop right there.
Praise God.
And just letting you know, let me read you this before I close. There's a song that we sing that I like. It says, he's God on the mountain.
Mm-hmm.
He's God in the valley.
Mm-hmm.
Whether you're up or low, he
mm-hmm.
says. And he says, when things are wrong, he makes them right.
Yes.
It says he's the God of the good times.
Mm-hmm.
And he's God of the bad times.
Yes.
He's the God of the day. And he's God of the night.
Again.
He didn't forget anything.
That's it.
We forget about him.
Mm-hmm.
Because we stop serving.
Mm-hmm.
And we start getting full of the world.
Mm-hmm.
And we start walking away.
Mm-hmm.
We need to feed our spirit the word of God.
Yes.
We need to renew our minds with the word of God so we don't get contaminated
mm-hmm.
and start being like the world.
Mm-hmm.
He says hot or cold, but not lukewarm.
That's it. Amen.
Amen. And it says your flesh wants all these nice little things. He says, but crucify the
yes.
flesh.
Yeah.
Crucify the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
Can't let the flesh have its own way.
That's it.
If you feed your spirit the word of God
mm-hmm.
and you renew your mind your soul, mind, will, and emotions with the word of God, your flesh, you're going to crucify
mm-hmm.
and be moved by the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So let's remember this. So, amen. That's the God we serve. He's greater than anything
yes.
we come against. So
yes.
praise God. So did you receive anything?
Yes.
I did.
Yes.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord. And some of you are watching, some of you are listening. And this is the year. I mean, why put it off anymore? Why put it off another day?
Mm-hmm.
This is the day that the Lord has made, and this is the day that you can come to Christ. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Just receive Him as your Lord and Savior. Say, Lord, I've been running all this time.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the year. This is the time. Amen. It says, I've sinned against you. Come into my heart, be my Lord and Savior. And He will. He will turn you down. God sacrificed His Son. Jesus gave His life for your salvation. Salvation is free, but you have to confess it and receive it for yourself.
Thank you.
Not from somebody else. Receive it for yourself. You speak it out. Lord, I need to. Come into my life, be my Lord and Savior. And He will. But now you start living for Him. You start going to a church where you can feed on the Word of God. Go to a place where they teach the Word. Where they speak the word. Amen.
Yeah.
And you start living for Him and start going and doing for Him.
Yeah.
Amen. So, whew, hallelujah.
Praise
what a blessing.
God.
If you have sickness in your body, I just confess what the word of God says. By His stripes, I am healed.
Amen.
And you know, I got to say that to myself all the time because my flesh is getting older. In my flesh, I got aches and pains and all these other things, you know. And there's malfunctions going on.
Yeah.
But I say, wait a minute. My body's a temple of the Holy Ghost.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not accepting no sickness. I'm not accepting no malfunctions in this body. Lord, You created this body. So I want every part of my body functioning in the way you created it to function. So body, line up with the word of God and be healed now in Jesus' name. Amen. So by his stripes I am healed. Woo, and it's time to give. Those who are watching, those who are listening, go to our website, nbcbigben.com, and hit that donate button. If you're mailing it, NBC PO Box 252, Marfa, Texas 79843, and Cash App now at New Beginnings Church of the Big Bend. God bless you. God loves you, and we love you. Amen. Praise God.